Welcome back, everybody, to Fallout 4, One Man's Quest in the Wasteland to find his lost baby. Okay, so last time, we spent some time doing some building of our settlement, and doesn't it look glorious and off balance? Actually, if you look at it here, it does look kind of on balance. It just, well, it's liable to fall over if there's a stiff breeze. Today, since we did some construction last episode, we're going to go exploring. But before we do, I leveled up a few times building that thing. Here's an updated look at the perk chart. So here's the stats right there. Pause it if you want to look at them closer. Then I've got a point in Gunslinger and Rifleman, Lone Wanderer, Gun Nut, which allows us to modify our gun, which we're going to do in just a second. Then I've got one in Sneak, one in Locksmith, and one in Ninja. So one of the points I put most recently that I got leveling up building all that stuff is the Gun Nut one, which lets us add new modifications, create new modifications for our weapons. So we're going to do that quickly right now. And we're going to do it to my main pistol, the Lawgiver, which I renamed because it kind of has the look of Judge Dredd's gun, the really bulky weapon that he likes to carry. So let's modify it and see what we can do now. So, oh wow, look at all of these. Holy cow. So I did have, I had a hardened receiver on here, and there's all kinds of receivers. But we can't do all these ones that are grayed out because we don't have rank 2 gun nut yet. And looking at them, I want to focus this thing on damage. And let's see, this thing says powerful receiver. Yeah, superior damage. The other ones increase the fire rate. And this is like armor piercing automatic. So I guess if you want to shred through some power armor, you would use that. But I think power armor is best. Look, we go from 26 to 32 damage. And as I put more points, let's do that one. Kershmackers. Oh, I got some experience doing that. Codsworth loved that. Codsworth tolerates you. What? All right. What was I going to say? I don't know. Long barrel. Long light barrel, so the only thing this modifies is the weight and the value. Alright, but let's go ahead, sure. Kerblam. Okay, and then the comfort grip. Okay, we can't use... Why can't I make this? Oh, I'm out of adhesive. So, I know that there is a way, or there probably is a way, to break down the items you find in the wasteland. Like, if you find duct tape, I bet you can break that down into adhesive. I don't know how to do that. I've sort of looked around how to do that. If maybe we need a certain station to break that stuff down. But I'm out of adhesive. I can't put that on there. I need adhesive to put a larger magazine or a quick eject magazine. I already added a reflex sight. So, and I can't do a recon sight. And then the muzzle. I need adhesive. Huh, okay. So, do I want to look at any other guns? Let's look at, double barrel shotgun. Maybe we'll look at this really quick, although I kind of guessed. Yeah, we're not going to be able to make a lot without that adhesive, so we'll just have to look, be on the lookout for that. Yeah, all this stuff takes adhesive. I guess you got to glue it together. That's what you need the adhesive for. And then the other weapon that's really good is this one. Let's just look at this real quick. Yeah, you can see on the right, available mods. They're all grayed out. I suspect because we are lacking that adhesive. But our main gun there, which I've only got like 50 bullets of, is quite a bit more powerful now. So that's good. Let's just look here in the workbench. This thing, unfortunately, you can't actually move that. Because I would place it up there if I could. But if we go into the transfer tab. Yeah, I did put all of my junk in here. Oh, wait, hang on, go back. There's a bunch of rounds in here. Give me all these rounds. 22 rounds. I will take those. So you can definitely break down the guns at the weapon modification workshop bench thing. You can break those down there. But things like Abraxo cleaner, acid antiseptic fiberglass, I'm not sure how to break that down. Maybe we would do that at a chemistry, at the chemistry workbench. Let's see if I can find duct tape. Okay, I don't see it there. I kind of suspect that there is a way to break this stuff down, though, and I just, maybe I just don't know how to do it yet. Anyway, we can worry about that some other time. It's not an emergency. Right this moment, we made our gun more powerful, and I got more ammo now. I've got 68. So our goal is to go basically straight south, and we will explore anything we see. So it's not like I'm gonna only go south. We're going south to explore some new area. And here's the map. So there's a bunch of roads here. This is probably a highway, so we want to investigate all the stuff around these roads. And then maybe even head down far enough to see what's up at this interchange way down there. And it is daytime, so we should be okay. Maybe I'll just do a quick save before we get too far. Okay, I'll take the coffee cup, because that's ceramic. And the drifter outfit. Need to start picking up all that kind of stuff. And now we're heading east, so I actually need to get off this road. Hey! Abernathy Farm!
That's close enough, stranger.
Uh-huh.
We're a peaceful farm.
Ah, shoot you in your nose! Okay.
Neither do I. Just passing through.
If you say so, but be warned, we're armed here, so don't try anything.
We'll shoot you in your face.
Farming ain't easy. Out in the field all day, every day, and every minute of it spent watching your back.
Okay, great. What do you grow here?
What kind of crops do you grow here?
Mostly potatoes so far.
Potatoes.
But we're starting on melons.
Great.
Lake Abernathy. You new to the Commonwealth?
Yep, kind of.
Yes. And no. It's a long story.
Either way, good to see a new face. How about you? Ever think about working the land?
Digging no. the dirt all day? No thanks.
You're probably a wiser man than me then.
Yep.
Word of advice though. If you do start up a farm, be ready to deal with the raiders.
Mm.
Why do all the hard work when you can just take what you want at gunpoint?
Yep. That's my thoughts.
Bastards. All of them.
Yeah.
Last time those raiders hit us, my daughter Mary tried to stand up to him. Now she's buried out back of the house.
Ooh.
Only 21 years old, and they shot her down without a thought. That's why we need the Minutemen back. And the sooner, the better.
Great. Okay, that sucks.
There's nothing worse than losing a child. Believe me, I know.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to hear you say so. I don't have much to offer, but those raiders that killed Mary, they took her locket, too.
Uh-huh.
It's been in Connie's family for generations.
I bet you want it back,
don't
you?
If you get it back, it'd mean a lot to us.
Would it mean a lot of bottle caps to you?
I'll see what I can do.
Good. Connie feels like it's a part of Mary. I don't think she'll rest easy again as long as it's gone.
Satellite Olivia. We were there before. That's where Ak-Ak or some name like that has a minigun. And what else did they have? A bunch of explosives, and they were just blowing me up left and right. Okay, so we can definitely go there. I'm gonna get steal some plants. I already have some of these, but maybe we'll want to plant some extra ones in our settlement. We'll just steal all their food. Oh, there's a workshop. Can I make this a settlement too? I guess we can make multiple. Oh, I like that. I might have to add some of these detail touches to mine. Okay, let's take a look around and steal everything that's worthwhile. Gas can. Oh, it's in red. I haven't seen red before. Everything's been freely available to take. Okay, so here's how you do it. Stimpak, I definitely want. We're hidden. And you just take it. Instamash, take it. Purified water, I definitely want the purified water. Noises! Oh, Nelly! Please explode your brain. Yes. Oh, God. Okay. Holy moly. Ratatouille. Need a little rat to make me some food. Oh, God.
Whoa! Okay, where's my Fusro Da? I want to knock him back. You're joking me. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Oh, we killed them. Wow. I was just trying to look at my weapons and they jumped me. Oh, I got a kickball. Nice. Okay, what was I doing? So here's the 45. Shotgun is on 4. This automatic one's on 5. Yeah, and this one's on 6. Ah, okay. Whatever. Stupid muties. Let me look at my inventory one more time. Bolt action rifle. Yeah, this is on 6. I thought I put this one on 6. Do they look so similar that it's hard to tell the difference? 6. I'm not sure what happened there. Probably doesn't matter that much because they're pretty similar, and that's my, like, if I'm out of everything else, I'll use that weapon. That's my slot for that. Farthest from 1. Ooh, looks like we've got a dam. Oh, and some kind of building over there. We should be able to maybe get a little bit of view. There's the assembly facility way over there. I keep pointing with my mouse click. Oh, doggy. Oh, okay. Got him. Those things are dangerous. And they've got yummy, yummy dog meat on them. Okay, let's go take a look at the dam right here. See what it has. And looks like there's a few buildings over there. I'm going to be sneaky, sneaky for just a little bit. Because there's a big structure here, I kind of expect to run into something. At some point, I'm going to take the perk that allows you to swim in the water and breathe the water, but more importantly, not get radiation from it. So we can explore the Boston Bay underwater. That sounds like fun. I haven't even made it to Boston proper yet, though, so that's... Maybe one day we'll get there. Okay, let's take a look. So there's a building right there. There's the highway. Okay, let's go see what's in that building. And there's no water in between us, so we can just go straight there. And I'm not gonna sneak. At least until we get a little bit closer. Because otherwise, it's gonna take all day. Walden Pond! Oh! Right! Wow! Okay! Yeah, there was like a book written here, right? Yeah, there's got to be something here. There's got to be. Automated tour.
Hello, and welcome to Walden Pond.
Oh, crazy. Is that it?
You are now standing in front of the cabin inhabited by transcendentalist writer and philosopher Henry David Thoreau, starting in the summer of 1845.
Wow. Keep going, I'm
for
looting.
2 years, 2 months, and 2 days, Thoreau lived in this cabin.
Huh.
Hoping to gain a more objective understanding of society.
This thing. Wow.
This experiment was influenced by Thoreau's interest in transcendentalist philosophy, which believed that people were at their best when truly self-reliant.
And doing drugs.
By living off the land with few material possessions, Thoreau proved it skeptical to think that any outward improvement of life could bring inner peace and contentment. For more information, please visit the gift shop and purchase one of the many books on transcendentalism.
Oh, wow. Please visit the gift shop. Please exit through
also
the gift shop.
T-shirts, coffee mugs,
t-shirts,
toys, and
coffee mugs, toys, many other items. Demonstrate your self-reliance by buying merchandise today. Jangles the Moon Monkey again. Maybe that's my second Jangles the Moon Monkey. We might have to have a Jangles the Moon Monkey collection. Most of these games, I have some sort of collection. In Skyrim, it was a giant jar full of gems. In Morrowind, it was pillows. which is weird. But I collected pillows in... This guy I can't collect. I've seen him before as well. In Morrowind, there was... I think it was because of a quest very early on in the game where you have to, I think, steal a dagger or something like that, and it's the person hides it under their pillow. So you gotta take the pillow. Gift shop basement.
Lock's really strong.
Dang! I don't have enough points in that yet. Note to Tweez. Tweez, if you're reading this, then you're an idiot. This is the last time I tell you, we're locking the door. Use the entrance in the sewer pipe. Next time you forget, I'm locking you out. Ooh, Walter. Okay, so we'll look for that. Okay, I've never failed at that. How would I have triggered it? I've never failed at disarming once you notice it. But I collected pillows after that point. Oh, there's another one. How am I supposed to set that off? I'm not sure. I collected pillows ever after doing that quest. For whatever reason, just that one quest made me want to collect pillows, and I ended up with this room full of pillows, like, filled to the sky, and I actually broke the map for that house, and I could no longer go in that house because it would crash the game because the save file got too big because I had so many pillows. I also had a lot of light sources and stuff like that. Okay.
Yes.
Great. Oh, great. Gray knit cap. Maybe it's getting a little chilly. Everything has bombs on it. Okay, let's try to find, maybe for the last part of the episode, let's try to find the sewer entrance to get into there. He said sewer entrance around, it should be right around here somewhere. That's a tire, that is not a sewer entrance. Okay, and it's not these dumpsters. Did he say it was around the back or something like that? Let's go look at the note again, because I'm pretty sure it said what to do. Whoa! Oh, that's, those things... Uh-huh. Those things are a camera, like a secret camera system. Use the entrance in the sewer pipe. Okay, it doesn't say where the sewer pipe is. It just says, use the entrance. Oh, I bet if this thing sees you, the bombs go off. And because I was sneaking, it didn't see me, so they didn't go off. And I defused them. Aha, I think that's what happened. Oh, there's a dude over here. Okay. Chem's vendor. Oh, all right. Hey, Chem's vendor. I'll talk to you. What do you have for sale?
Hi.
Hey, man. You need some chems?
Yeah, I sure do. Whew.
You sell chems?
If you're asking whether I'll sell you my chems, the answer is yes.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Alright.
This is all I've got at the moment.
Okay. You've got Radex, Psycho, Mentats, The Freshmaker, Medex, Jet, Buff Out, and Addictol. Cures all addictions. Hmm. Buff outs gives you strength and endurance and max hit points. Jet slows time. Medex gives you damage reduction. Mentats, intellect and perception. Psycho is damage resistance and increased damage. That one's pretty good. Do I have psycho? I've got 7. I guess I have a lot of drugs, don't I? I already have a bunch of drugs, dude. Okay, have a good day. We gotta find a sewer pipe to get into this basement, because I can't pick the lock yet. That's why, in these games, almost immediately, I start going for either lockpick or hacking, because usually with one or the other, you can get into a lot of places early, which gets you a lot of loot, a lot of bottle caps, a lot of good stuff. And this time, I've started with lockpicking. I'll eventually pick up hacking as well. Aha! I bet that's it right there. That's gotta be it, right? Looks like a sewer pipe to me. Let's see if we can get in here without... Yeah, without taking radiation. Alright. Okay, let's sneak. This has gotta be it, right? Ooh, and there's a sewer system. This is kind of gross and stinky.
So this guy made sure he had everything he needed before he started his camping trip in that little shack up top. Double-checked his list and everything.
Uh-oh.
And that's why they call it being the rogue.
Wow, that's hilarious.
And this guy invented transal...
Transcendentalism, moron. You sound like an idiot.
How the hell you know all this?
I read a book that one time, when we ran out of grognacks.
I wish I could read.
Okay, they don't like me. They put up their weapons automatically. They're red.
Okay, cut the shit. Who is that?
Something there now.
What do you think?
I don't know. Jumping in shadows.
Alright. Who wants to die? Bear? You're dead. No, maybe you're not. Maybe you are. Okay. Oh, you're dead. Stick your face around here, sucker! Oh, you're shooting me. Oh. Alright, they're dead. Got it. Oh, that was a little bit easier than I expected. Assault gas max plus. That just means it's, I think that just means it has better armor than what I'm wearing, which is nothing on my face. There's someone over there, but they're stupid because they can't respond to freaking gunfire. Okay, weird mannequins. So I was going to try to talk to them, but since they pulled out their weapons just because someone was nearby means, I think that means more or less they're automatically hostile no matter what. I'm hearing stuff. I'm just going to take all this stuff and we'll change it into the base materials later. I'll store it in my workbench or whatever. Each of these probably turns into one unit of glass, if I were to guess. And I did blows them up pretty easily, I gotta say. And there's at least one other... Was that a trap? What was that all about? Hey, we got a mannequin set up, and it's gonna fall over if anybody comes in here, so they better watch out. And I don't have that much ammo for this thing, so maybe if close range, let's use a shotgun. That's a good idea. That's a fantastic idea. This has got to be... Yeah, tin cans! Awesome! And experience get! Huh? Hey, come over here. Alright, let's try. Let's try this one. Oh, it's bolt action. Uh-oh. Slow. You don't even... Do you see me? I guess you do.
Open fire.
Oh, they're shooting me.
Don't quit, do you?
All right, I'm not very good at shooting guns. I don't play first-person shooters very much, so let's do... Whatever. Wow, hard to miss at this range. And you're dead. Okay, ooh, I lost a lot of health. Let's have a stab in my stomach. Whiplash. I wonder if we could have been friends with these guys somehow, but because I came in the way I did, they were automatically enemies? Like, I don't... I would like to... Oh, he had a gift shop key. I would like to, you know, get along with the villains in the world and, engage in some jolly cooperation as we wreak havoc all across the wasteland? I'm not sure. Okay, unlock. All this kind of stuff. Fragmentation grenades, awesome. And some drugs, awesome. Nice, all right. Not too bad, not too shabby. Let's see if we can find anything else in here. And then we can probably exit through the gift shop as the, there's a documentary called that, by the way. That's why I've said it like three times. Glass bowl. Brooms. I guess the broom would break down too, wouldn't it? So maybe we should take it. Okay. And stairs. Oh, that's probably it right there. And they had set up that monkey to That monkey was there to detect intruders. Maybe if I had just hung out there long enough.
Yes.
Whoa. Big Jim. 20% chance to cripple the target's leg. Is this important somehow? It usually doesn't zoom in like that when I find something. Maybe that's some kind of like rare item or something. And I'm, yep, there we go. I'm encumbered. Mining helmet. So I think I'll take everything and then drop the least valuable thing. Was that a bomb? These things you can use to make bottle cap bombs or mines. So they're actually pretty worthwhile to take. And there is nothing there. All right, I think that's probably a good spot. I can stop sneaking now. That's a good spot to end the video. We did quite a bit. We looted quite a bit. We explored a little bit. Next time, I think we'll probably continue exploring. Let's look at the world map. We didn't even make it all the way down to this highway yet. So we'll probably continue south and see what's up down here. Next time. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. See you next time. Bye-bye.